BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston. Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
So welcome to Hereford's Flame Celebration. Thank you for staying out. Look, we're left with the most diehard of music supporters, which means we're left with the noisiest. Our next artist has been performing in folk clubs and acoustic music venues for many years, and in fact, in the late 1990s was gracing stages at places like Warwick, Redditch, Bromyard and Bridge North on the main stages there. She's actually joined with Duncan Gibbs, who, although has got two instruments on stage today, plays 12 instruments on the brand new CD. So ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together and welcome Sarah Jones.
Thank you.
Good, I have to say, you look like a dream when you came my way. As the months went by, the dream turned bad. You were about the worst friend that I ever had. Enough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. Will you come home at night, hit the bottle and then bend my ear over nothing again? All night long, till you made me cry. I'm getting out, you can stay here and die. Rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. That's the chorus if you fancy it. Dance to keep warm. Ooh, rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. You don't wanna do this, don't wanna do that. You bleed me dry, you're a low-down rat. You hate all my friends, you laugh in my car. Spend my wage in the nearest bar. Rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. Ooh, rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. When you say you're in love, I'd say that's true. You love a three-letter word, and that word is you. So you'd better listen good, you'd better listen well. Living with you is like living in hell. You screw me up, you drag me down. Never have fun when you're around. Rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. Ooh, rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone. Ooh, rough love, never get enough love. Baby, I'm gone.
Okay, well listen, it's getting a bit chilly out there. We're gonna give you a couple of tunes you can dance to. The first one is called Sweet Feet, which someone named at a gig because I said I didn't have a name for it. And the other one's called Aching Side.
unsigned,
undiscovered, and under the radar music.
Thank you.
Sarah Jones, well played. You kept the crowd to the end. They're all singing along.
They did sing along. That was very nice. And the last song, it's going to be all right. It's the first time we've sung it out, actually. It was good.
It's rare you come across a song where you almost feel it 30 seconds into it that you know it. It's something which has got a familiar feel.
Yeah, it has.
And I think that really kind of resonated with some of the people who were propping up the crowd barrier here at the front.
I think it did. I think, you know, you need a couple of songs like that in a set.
I like the way that, you know, yourself as a singer, also allow some of the music to breathe, in the sense that the second song which you did, Ian, he thought, actually, I'm going to do this as an instrumental. That takes a harsh music discipline almost.
I mean, one of the things about the folk tradition is we have all these kind of jigs and reels and stuff, and although, you know, I wrote those too and everything, it's nice to kind of draw from that tradition from time to time and just mix it up a bit.
And you're on stage with Duncan, who's featured on your new album.
Yeah.
Plays 12 different instruments.
He does.
I'm going to get you to list them.
Yeah, okay, all right. Bass, guitar, keyboards, bowed psaltery, which is a, well, it's bowed and it sounds very sweet. Percussion, dobro, I've forgotten the rest of that. Oh, melodica, he plays melodica, accordion, some penny whistles, and flute.
How on earth do you meet someone who can play so many instruments?
I met him about 30 years ago, and I have never let him out of my sight since.
13 or 30?
30, 3-0.
Oh,
and we were in a band together then, and through the years we've done different things, but we just work well together, you know. I love him, he's a genius, and we complement each other, so it's nice.
Tell me about some of the other stages that you've played on, because there's been some pretty significant ones.
Yeah, I mean, in the 1990s we were doing sort of main stages of the big folk festivals like Warwick and Bridge North, which is now Shrewsbury and everything, and that was just terrific, you know. And then life moves on and bands change and things, but we kind of feel with the new album we'd like to think we might be sort of having a chance to have a second go at some of that, you know. We still do one tour every year, that's fun, you know, but it has to fit in around other things.
Yeah, I was gonna say, how do you get the time off work to be able to do that?
This is the problem, and there just is no time in life at all, so you squeeze the plane and the practicing into kind of odd little hours in the middle of the night. But so it's great to come and have a little run out.
Okay.
It's nice.
And what is the day job?
I'm a Church of England priest.
Really?
So
where's the collar?
I've got my cross on. I'm not sewn into it, so I can take my collar off every now and then when I come and do things. So I take 3 weeks off at the parish each year and we do a UK tour. And the rest of the time, it kind of takes a very, very back seat.
Okay, so where's your churches then?
Ross-on-Wye and Walford, yeah.
And what do the congregation make of this? Obviously, you've got to lead the hymns.
Yes.
Do you ever try and play that?
No. I think
you keep the two very separate.
I keep the two very separate because otherwise it becomes all about me, and the churchy bit is not about me at all, you know. Other people do the music and that's great.
You could have exploited that. You could have been like the musician's minister or something like that.
Quite possibly. I'm not dead yet though, so maybe.
So obviously you're going to have to take your sabbatical to almost go on tour. What came first then? Was it the music or was it the ministry?
I always played guitar even from when I was a little kid. So from when I was 10, you know, I was playing guitar. So I guess really I've been doing that longer.
You say you have to keep the two very separate, but obviously, you know, when you're touched by God and spirit, presumably that also reflects in the lyrics which you write.
Yeah, it does in a sense. I mean, I have written some worship songs, but we don't do them. I can't cut out the fact that I believe in a God. So shot through some of the songs are kind of references to, like, the great beyond. But it's not something that people have a problem singing, and people are very happy singing these kind of lyrics. So I think that's a nice line to walk, actually. It's not, you know, pushing any particular line. It's just saying, well, hey, there's something out there. That doesn't mean I can't mention it in a song, you know?
Well, you're a real inspiration, and thank you for coming down today and performing some great music and doing the great work that you do.
Andrew, thanks very much. We've loved every second of it.
BBC introducing in Hereford and Worcester
with Andrew Marston.
Be part of it.
Sing. job in a factory down Dead End Road. No point to leaving, nowhere to go. Then a voice in my head said, let me see. Better run for your life and set you free.
This will be the last song from us and the last song of the evening. But if I teach you the chorus and it's a simple one, will you sing it? Yeah. Fantastic. Having just sung a kind of sad song, we're going to send you home happy with a song where the chorus is, it's going to be all right. It's going to be all right. I'm done with dull and darkness. Gonna make it home tonight. It's going to be all right. Going to be all right. There's several of those. You'll learn it as you go along and feel free to dance. Basically, the chorus is, it's going to be all right. First two songs were on our new album, which comes out in a couple of weeks. And then we're on a UK tour in October. Sarah Jones, do check us out on the website. The last song, the soulful one, was on the album before that.
Now life is full of promise, my mother said to me. As I walk through this hard world, it's not the world I see. The road gets ever longer, this mountain's hard to climb. I sure could do with one true friend here in this life of mine. It's gonna be alright, it's gonna be alright. I'm done with dull and darkness, gonna take it to the light. It's gonna be alright, it's gonna be alright. I'm through with hesitating, gonna take it home tonight. My life is dull and boring, hell, I ain't going nowhere. I'm looking at these four cold walls. I've nothing new to wear. I need to hear some music, feel the rhythm in my veins. I need to move my body, leave behind my pain. You ready? It's gonna be alright. It to the line, I gotta be alright. It's gonna be alright. I'm through with hesitating. Gonna take it home tonight. When my time is over, when my living's all been done, when my bones are cracked and broken, my race has all been run. Well, I've been down and dirty, yeah, I've been lost and found, but I stand before my maker right here on holy ground. Here we go, it's gonna be alright. To the light, it's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. I'm through with hesitating. Gonna take it home tonight. Everybody, it's gonna be alright. It's gonna be alright. I'm done with darling darkness. Take it home tonight. It's gonna be alright. Take it home tonight. I'm through with hesitating. Gonna take it home tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Duncan Gibbs!
See our session snaps right now.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
Sarah Jones, what do you think of her music?
It was really cool. It was a really nice change.
What kind of stuff do you normally go out and listen to?
Dance music.
Okay, so that last act was almost something really different to what you normally go out and...
Yeah, but it's really bouncy. It was lively in comparison to some of what the previous music had been.
I think it was absolutely brilliant.
It was fab.
I really do think people should have stayed.
Because at the end of the day, Cameron was fantastic.
So you're here for the flame itself, just to kind of
We're
describe
here for the whole
that.
Thing.
I just described that moment as well, and what happened?
Meeting Cameron, he came and spoke to everybody, and he was such a beautiful person. Really generous.
Horse naughty.
Yeah, he said the horse was naughty.
Yeah, we should explain actually. The horse came in front of the speakers. Cameron was trying to talk into the mic, and it almost looked like the horse was about to bolt. So
he had to drop the mic. He did have to drop the mic, but actually, the whole atmosphere, the whole day has been absolutely fantastic. I just wish more people had trusted the British weather.
What did you think of the last act?
I thought it was really good.
What sort of music do you like?
I like dance music and party music.
Okay. Was that like party music, particularly that last song?
Yeah.
You know, 10 o'clock at night, you had a few beers. Have some fun.
I thought it was actually pretty good.
Okay.
Celebrating my birthday.
Oh, it's your birthday today?
Yeah, and okay. It won the CD for the best dancer.
Best dancer, yeah. Okay. So you've been dancing all night, so just describe the dance routine.
Shake your head and body, basically.
Okay.
And dance.
Enjoy yourself.
Yes.
They were quite good. They were quite chilled out. Definitely good at this time of night. Instead of having like a proper pure on rock band, I think it was nice just to have something a little bit different, a little bit more country. I thought they were very good, actually, yeah.
You're Stuart in here today. Does that mean you're giving up your time for free?
I am, very happily so. It's been a very good day. We've been given lots of care, lots of sort of drinks and keep us hydrated, and I've made lots of new friends anyway, so it's definitely worthwhile.
And how would you describe that last act which you saw?
It definitely got the crowd going. A good way to end the evening.
I thought they were pretty good performances, to be honest.
Okay.
Quite sort of calm music.
relaxed and good to listen to, really.
Just describe what that crowd were like.
Really enthusiastic about it, really sort of cheering along with it all and being upbeat, to be honest.
And have you enjoyed it this year as a volunteer?
I have. I can say it's been a pretty good day. It's been a nice outcome, being a visitor and a sort of a worker and that, so can't really complain.
And what a year to say that you volunteered in 2012 for, you know, this huge event that we've got on our doorstep.
It's quite a huge event, to be honest with you. It doesn't happen, not often anyway. It's the first one in a while for Britain, really, isn't it? So it's really good, really.
If you're writing music in Herefordshire and Worcestershire, be part of it. Upload your music to bbc.co.uk/Hereford
and Worcester
/introducing.